Hi everybody, Dan Finlay here. I thought I'd do a quick video explaining the mat auction. I made this little interactive web app to explain it, but it's not perfectly obvious at first glance, so I'm just going to go through it. So like it says, in a mat auction, the seller decides how many additions to mint when closing the auction, and your bid just represents the most you're willing to pay to get an addition, but you're guaranteed to not pay more than any other winner. So basically, when the auction closes, the person selling has to pick what price they're going to sell at, and they're generally going to pick the price where they're making the most. So here's the price per item on the x-axis, and then they're looking for the maximum revenue. So the winning bid right now is right over here. You can see it's $5. So the current winning price is $5, which will produce 16 additions. So if you counted all these bars here, that's 16 bids that are good here, and net the artist $80. So you can see that's $80 bid. But you know, you can see over here, there are four people who are willing to pay $10. It's just that, you know, 4 times 10 is only 40, and there's just far more people willing to pay $5. So this is a type of auction that's designed for finding the best price, the best number of additions to sell to get something. Now, sometimes people care about how many editions of something there are. You know, like if you're an art collector, you might want to know this is a one of one or one of two, or one of no more than 10. And that's a kind of parameter you could build on top of this. But this one's strictly about, you know, the basic example here is when people don't care. So you could imagine giving out licensing rights to something. One possible application I thought of was, let's say you were a pharmaceutical company and you wanted to auction off the rights to your vaccine. Well, you know, one of the reasons the vaccine has been a little slow to get around is usually they're giving out those rights to just a single top bidder. But a you know, single bidder here may just be winning by a little bit, but there could be a ton of other companies that would all be willing to pay a lower amount, and it would might actually net the company more if they were willing to sell that. So just to demonstrate the whole thing, let's say we wanted to place a bid here. Let's say place a $100 bid. I place a $100 bid, and you can see $100 as a single bid nets more than all of those $5 bidders before. And so in this set of bids, the seller's best move is to just pay $100. But what if somebody came in and then they also bid $51? Well, now there's two people willing to pay $51. And so with two additions, the seller's able to get $102. And so hopefully you can see here how the mat auction kind of helps an artist figure out the optimal number of additions to get the best price. Let's just try another one here. Let's add a 75 and place a bid there. Ah, look at that. With 75, it bumps the $51 bid. Now there's three people willing to pay 51. It's only actually bumping it by the $51 again, right? So it's 153. It's not bumping it by the 75 because 75, it wasn't enough at 75 for two bids to make any difference, right? So it's always looking for what's the price where the most people or the greatest total revenue is going to be found. Of course, there can be situations where there are multiple bumps at the same place. You can click randomize bids and try to create some interesting shapes. And to me, the most interesting ones are where you start to get like two peaks that are kind of similar. Here we got 4 and 6 are both pretty close. In fact, I think they may both be minting $72 here. In this scenario, the artist or the seller actually can choose which price to go at. You know, maybe you do want fewer people to have it, fewer customers to deal with, or maybe you really do want to proliferate it as widely as possible. So anyways, those are just two ways to do it. Again, there are a lot more dimensions that you could add to a mat auction. The buyer could say, I'm not going to mint more than this many additions. The seller could say, you could have a limit on additions. But buyers could also, you could have constraints on the bid. You could say, this bid is only good if there's going to be fewer than 10 additions. I'm not interested in those. And if we were in that scenario, we'd have to have another dimension on this graph. So this graph wouldn't be useful for that. Another cool thing is that this can totally work with the bids being off-chain. These bids only have to be commitments to pay. So this is a kind of NFT auction that can avoid a kind of gas auction where everyone's just trying to do a first come first serve purchase. You can actually leave one of these sales open for whatever amount of time you want, and then once the market is ripe or the seller's happy, they can then submit end the auction, redeem their revenue, and issue the NFTs or rights that they were auctioning off. Also, since the bids are off chain, you could make this a blind auction. There's nothing that keeps this from being a blind auction. So basically every person signs a commitment to pay at that price under those terms, and then the seller's collecting these signed commitments, and once they have some commitments, they can submit them. One reason you might want to do that is if you could imagine if this was a blank slate, well, people might just start at the lowest price possible, and then people say, oh, well, look, I can get it at the lowest price possible, and everyone might just pile in at a dollar. There's probably an advantage to people, you know, not being sure that they're going to get it right off the bat. So it might actually be better to do this as a blind auction. But the visualization at the very least is useful for helping understand how the mechanism works. Yeah, okay. Well, anyways, I hope that this has been a useful explanation. I know it's been a little bit tricky for people to understand when it's been described before, but hopefully this web app and video helps explain the mechanism. Anyways, I've been working on the contracts over the weekends. I think they're coming along kind of good. It feels good to write a little solidity again. I've been doing so much just making wallet that sometimes I've been missing out on that stuff. So anyways, I hope this has been fun for you, and you know, hope that you might try this out in the future, because you know, the gas wars are a real pain, and we deserve to give artists the maximum revenue that they can get, and not just artists, but creators in general. Cool. Have a good one.